Hello everyone, and welcome to the Sidequest Quest, a gathering of old friends. You're enlisted in a speak test that may not be what it seems. Can you help Dumbledore with this quest? List for a mysterious gathering. Hurry, my glowsbugs are getting away. Oh, there you are, Melody. I hate to bother you, but I don't have much time, and I could really use your help. What's wrong, Hagrid? Dumbledore gave me the honor of helping him decorate for a gathering in Godric's Hollow. A gathering in Godric's Hollow? That's a little vague. It doesn't have anything to do with Ragnar's Crypt, does it? Oh no, nothing like that. Afraid I can't say much more. Sworn the sorcery, you see. Only I got a little excited about using glowbugs. They liked the proceeding, and well, I spilled the jar. They are escaping into my garden. What's worse, Dumbledore will be by any minute to check it on Finch. I don't want him to think he can trust me. Don't worry, Hagrid. If we act fast, I'm sure we can gather all the glowbugs before Dumbledore gets here. In return, perhaps he will tell me a little bit more about this secret gathering. Well, I can't tell you who will be there. But I will tell you what. If you help me with these glowbugs, I will tell you whatever else I can. Just don't be expecting me to spill any secrets. So they keep a low profile so they won't be bothered. These glowbugs move quite quickly. Do glowbugs eat pumpkins? What about pumpkin pasties? There must be quite a few missing if we are going to fill that whole jar. Are you sure you can't tell me even one name or two? Dumbledore wants to make it quite special. No glowbugs over there. I think I see one. Some of them might have wriggled into these vines. We are gathering in Godric's Hollow Village Square. That's all the glowbugs. Thank you, Betty. What a relief. These little feathers give off a brilliant, ambient light. Perfect for an intimate gathering, if you say so myself. It's nice of Dumbledore to arrange a gathering of old friends, especially one who haven't seen one another in a long time. Yeah, most of Dumbledore's guests prefer to keep a low profile, which is why I've got to keep this guest list quiet, you see. Curious to hold the gathering in the village square, then. It's a very public spot, and right by the Potter Memorial, which I imagine can draw a crowd. Oh well, this idea, you see, all his kids were quite close to Lily and James. It's clever because the spot holds special significance, and they won't want to miss it. Shouldn't have said that. Dumbledore guests were all friends with Lily and James Potter. I should not have said that. Ha ha, it's nice to see all is going well with the decoration. Of course, Professor, no trouble at all. Got the globe books right here. Then perhaps you can help me with another important task. But I must say I'm surprised to find you here, Miss Van. I trust Hagrid hasn't been talking out of turn. Has Hagrid told you anything he shouldn't have? No, you can't trust Hagrid. Of course not. You can't trust Hagrid, Professor. I see. You are a loyal friend, Miss Van, and you're right to stick up for Hagrid. He's quite reliable. All I really know is that you are holding a gathering in the Godric Center of Village Square. As a far to none, I hope to reunite old friends who have been drawn apart by difficult circumstances. But it is precisely those times when old friends make all the difference. It's thoughtful of you to arrange such an opportunity, Professor. I'm sure your guests will appreciate all the work you and Hagrid have done. I do hope so. That's actually why I'm here. Three guests have not yet responded to the letter I sent. I'd like Hagrid to follow up with them and confirm if they are coming. I very much like to help you, Professor, but it's quite important. I'm not sure I'm your man. If it were magical creatures you were talking about, I know just what to do. But for something like this, you might want someone who is quite good with people, like Bellady. You really think I could help? Sure, Dumbledore said himself that you are a very good friend, a trustworthy. Not to mention, you are great with people. If you believe it will complete the task, Miss Van can go. But you must stick together, and she must not miss any classes. And given the private nature of my guest, I trust you both not to pry. Of course not, Professor Dumbledore. Now, who should we talk to first? The three guests you will need to visit are Mundungus Fletcher, Remus Lupin, and Aberforth Dumbledore. That sounds like quite an electric group, Professor. I wonder what they all have in common. The things that bind us are often less surprising than those that bite poodles apart. Well, I'm surprised you need us to talk with Aberforth. He is your brother, after all. My brother and I have a complicated history. It would mean a great deal to me if he was present. But I suspect Aberforth will be more moved by your words than mine in this instance. I will do my best to make sure he attends, Professor. As for Remus Lupin, I wonder if he will remember me. If you had contact with Remus, then you are clearly the right person for the job. I've been trying for some time, but to no avail. He keeps quite intently to himself. Mundungus should be easy enough. I think I have his number. Good, I recommend you start with him. You will find him at the Three Broomsticks. Perhaps he can point you to the others. We won't let you down, Professor. We will meet Mundungus at the Three Broomsticks and talk to him about your gathering in Godric's Hollow. If you are looking to talk to Mundungus, he is just arrived. Come to enjoy a full barrels of butterbeer, have you, Hagrid? I got my eye on that one over there. Some of this was for sale. Items look quite familiar. Dumbledore seemed a bit distracted lately, more than usual. Dashing a silver locket for a laughing, or perhaps a blessed mirror, told to the old Mundungus. Whatever you are missing, I'm sure I have it. Mundungus, remember me? Of course I remember you, Bellison. Oh, the old marauders map treating you. I'm sure I can't interest you in some omnoclus or perhaps an enchanted razor. We are here on behalf of Albus Dumbledore. He asked us to follow up with you on his invitation to a gathering in Godric's Hollow. Told you about that, did he? Dumbledore must trust you quite a bit. And he must trust you to want you at his private gathering. Will you come? Oh, I'd love to. Only I'm flat broke, you see. I should really focus on selling my wares. Then again, if someone are willing to help me sell everything in my bag, perhaps I could find the time. Are you saying you will only come if I help you sell everything in your bag? Of course I'm not saying that. All I'm saying is everything in my bag was sold, then I have time to journey to Godric's Hollow. If someone were willing to help, this is. Fine, Mundungus, I will help sell your wares. But you better keep up your end of the deal. But I first need some more energy. I've got quite a variety. In her priority, you will see. Don't forget, the enchanted tea gators are very rare. Perhaps you will let me show you how to wear this self-inking quill. I'm not much of a salesman, but I'm sure you will do a fine job. I could use a new writing utensil. Alright, let me take a look. You're not going to get this prize anywhere else, folks. Get you one kind of scrying mirror right here. The trick is to selling is knowing how to read people. Who could use a nice bit of jewelry? I've got quite a variety, you will see. Don't forget the enchanted tea kettle, very rare. And advantage is knowing. Perhaps you will let me show you how to work this self-inking quill. I'm not much of a salesman, but I'm sure you will do a fine job. Could I interest you in a pair of omnioculars? Right, let me take a look. You're not going to get this prize anywhere else, folks. Get your one-of-a-kind scrying mirror right here. The trick to selling is knowing how to read people. That's everything. I sold it all. And I suppose you helped a bit, Melody. Now that we sold your wares, will you come to Godric's Hollow for Dumbledore's gathering? Keep acting like you don't trust me and I am liable to get offended. I only want to be certain. It was quite important to Dumbledore that you came. I'm touched. It meant that much to him. To be honest, I don't hear much from the orders these days. I will keep up my end of the deal. I will be there. That's what you said. What was what you said about the order? Alright, this is enough. Remember, Dumbledore said not to pry. We better get a move on, Melody. We still have more people to see. I suppose you're right, Hagrid. We know Aberforth is likely to be At all heads, but I'm not sure about Remus Lupin. Do you know where we might find him, Dungus? Lupin, haven't heard from him in years. Here will be to the Hogheads Inn next. We will talk to Aberforth and Dumbledore gathering in Goddard's Hollow, then we will be nearly done. It is probably an event for everyone who is in the Order of the Phoenix. Spoiler alert, if I'm right, I have no idea. Let's go find Aberforth and Dumbledore. Never seen this place so crowded. Really too early for a tipple. Nor is it often too late. Harry kneels out of Gondor's hollow, I hear. Screaming, they say. Howling. There's Dumbledore's brother, Melody. You're up. Excuse me, Mr. Dumbledore. Call me Aberforth, Melody. It's a pleasure to see you again. I've come to ask you about Dumbledore's gathering in Godric's Hollow. You haven't responded to his invitation. I see, my brother sent you in his stead. I'm sorry to say, I got my hands full at the moment. In fact, I really should be getting back to work. Are you saying you won't come? I should think not. My brother and I don't get on like we used to. I'm not sure he really wants me there, to tell the truth. Why would you say that? Because I can't think of any reason Albus want me there. I don't suppose you could either. It would mean a lot to Dumbledore. Dumbledore said it would mean a lot to him. Ah, I see. It means so much that he sent a student on his behalf. Belly is more than a mere student. She is one of the finest witches Hogwarts has ever seen. Dumbledore has sent her because you ignored your invitation. He's giving you space. But don't think Bellady being here on Dumbledore's account is anything shorter than an honor. You've got my attention, but I'm still not convinced I should attend. Then let me convince you. I will tell you all I know about Dumbledore's gathering in Godric's Hollow, then you can decide once and for all. But I really need some more energy. Might they have enjoyed just one quick butterbeer, seeing as we are here all. Dumbledore says this group was quite important to one another at one point. It won't be the same without you, I'm sure. Less chatting, more drinking. You will want to see the decorations I've prepared. You should see the lands Dumbledore and Hagrid have gone. It's been years since you've all gathered. Do you really want to miss it? How many more opportunities like this will you have? They don't really want me there, do they? But who will pour the bitters while I'm gone? Might have to enjoy just one quick bitter, seeing as we are all here. I don't think you'd still be listening if you weren't interested. Dumbledore says this group was quite important to one another at one point. Is anyone serving drinks around here? And out of energy. Less chatting, more drinking. Yeah, want to see the decorations I've prepared. I won't be the same without you, I'm sure. But who will pour the bitterbeers while I'm gone? Might have to enjoy just one quick bitterbeer, seeing as we are all here. You could see the lands Dumbledore and Hagrid have gone to. It's been years since you've all gathered. Do you really want to miss it? You're right. If Dumbledore is gathering who I think he is, I haven't seen that lot in years. But we fought together. And though we were ultimately victorious, we are all suffered a great loss together. Our lives have changed considerably, but they still mean a good deal to me. Most of them, at least. Does that mean you will come? Yes, I suppose I will. You're right, Rubius. This is one remarkable young witch. Told you. The stool of the list, Bertie. Brilliant work. The only one left to talk is Lupin. If we can find him, that is. Lupin, I haven't heard from him in ages. That's a shame. We are hoping you might be able to help us find him. We are a bit of loss for where to look. I'm sorry to say I have no idea to start. Supposing we can find him, Dumbledore will still be pleased with your success, Bellady. 2 out of 3 ain't bad, and we are running out of time. You can tell Dumbledore the good news about this too, and I will get started on the decorations. Alright, I will head back to Hogwarts and tell Dumbledore about Madungus and Aberforth. Perhaps he will have an idea of where to look for Lupin. This meeting is running long, but come when you can. Under no circumstances can there be a gathering in Godric's Hollow. I'm sure you can appreciate that my guests and I will not willing put anyone in danger, Cecile. Even so, until this issue has researched its resolution, a message is you follow my instructions on the letter. On the matter of werewolves, I think you will find me quite obtuse. I believe you mean obstinate, Cecile. I mean what I mean. I better not interrupt. I hide until they are finished. Perhaps I will even learn a bit more about Dumbledore's guests. Now I'll only say this one more time, so listen close. I'm sure Dumbledore knows how to handle this. I've received multiplying reports of werewolf cries in Godric's Hollow. Perhaps you do not know as much as you think you do, Cecile. If they were for that friendly half giant, I never have learned your deducious plan. Dumbledore appears quite confident. And out of energy. Could this werewolf have something to do with Dumbledore's gathering? You simply must not gather in Godric's Hollow during this crisis. He is so upset. This must be dangerous. I must insist you let the professional handle this. I assure you my guests are well informed and quite capable. You have different ideas and as how to this situation to handle. I received multiple reports of werewolf cries in Godric's Hollow. Perhaps you do not know as much as you think you do, Cecile. If I weren't for that friendly half giant, I'd never have learned your deducious plans. I'm sure Dermot knows and know how to handle it. Could this werewolf have something to do with Dumbledore's gathering? Dumbledore appears quite confident. As you see, my hands are tired. Several locals reported nightly cries of a werewolf in Goddard's Hollow. Upon further investigation, I discovered a half-giant hanging light bulbs near the Potter Memorials. Oh, how did they look? Quite nice, actually. But don't distract me. My super laxative skills are interrogant, reveal your intentions, so I had to rush straight here. Getting rid of the werewolf loose will only increase the number of suspects and put the winners in danger. You have made your point perfectly clear, Cecile. Now what do you think, Miss Van? I didn't want to interrupt. Forgive me, Professor Dumbledore. I believe you already know Cecile Lee of the Mysterious Werewolf Capture Department. Of course, Bellady is an honor member of our unit. Perhaps, Professor Dumbledore. Hello again, Mr. Lee. Apologize for spying. You have good instincts, Bellady. Spying is a very important part of investigative work. Does Cecile have a good argument? Do we have a report warrant counseling gathering in Godric's Hollow? Cecile is wrong about everything. It is safe. I think Cecile is wrong about everything, Professor. Preposterous. I am right. At least some amount of 100% of the time. Even so, if Dumbledore believes it's safe, so do I. I appreciate your faith you place in me, though I assure you Cecile's heart is in the right place. You will both be happy to know there is no cause for alarm. You may think that now, but werewolves can be quite befuddling. A werewolf can make for a dangerous adventure, but the guests I'm gathering are perfectly capable of handling this one. The truth is, I was already aware of this werewolf. I have a plan for exactly how to end it. I hope that we'll save the ministry here. You too? Yes, and with that in mind, I will ask you to excuse us for now, Mr. Lee. I'd like to speak to the honorary member of your werewolf capture unit in private. With her help, I believe we can satisfy the werewolf capture unit concerns. Together, we will solve this werewolf problem safely and in time for my gathering in Godric's Hollow. Dumbledore asked you to help Penny revisit a painful tragedy from her past. Come as soon as you can. Time is of the essence. Hello, Professor. You said you wanted to talk to me in private. In the time I've known you, you have proven to be a very trustworthy friend. And you helped me with party guests proved you are quite capable with those who have unique personalities. I appreciate that, but I was only able to talk with two of them. I still haven't spoken with Lupin, but I will. Do you think he might know something about the werewolf in Godric's Hollow? Remus isn't one to arrive early for a party. Whatever this werewolf is, I believe he can safely deal with them and hold my gathering as planned. What do you need me to do, Professor? The truth is, I know a little more about the werewolf than I have let on. You do? I will explain to you. Then you will know you can help me protect my gathering and the people of Godric's Hollow. But I need some more energy for that. If I can help Professor Dumbledore, I will. I have a favor to ask you, and it will not be easy. How come the paintings move, but not the statues?
Your friend Penny once suffered a tragedy in the woods near Wigtown. I believe this werewolf may be tied to an attack what happened near Wigtown. Do you think the werewolf is dangerous, Professor? The truth is, I've been aware of this werewolf for some time. Thank you for confiding in me, Professor. Even frightening things benefit from understanding. Dumbledore must really trust me. The stillness of the water has a calming quality. If I can help Professor Dumbledore, I will. I have a favor to ask you, and it will not be easy. How come the paintings move but not the statues? Do you think the werewolf is dangerous, Professor? Your friend Penny once suffered a tragedy in the woods near Wigtown. Thank you for confiding in me, Professor. I believe this werewolf may be tied to an attack that happened near Wigtown. Even frightening things benefit from understanding. Truth is, I've been aware of this werewolf for some time. Blimey, you traced the werewolf in Godric's letter to an attack near Wigtown. And you believe it has something to do with what happened to Penny's friend, Scarlet? That's what I believe. If I'm right, Penny will be able to resource in locating and handling the werewolf. And here is where you come in. As Penny trusts a friend, I'd like you to speak with her and find out if she is willing to revisit that summer. I am sure it will be hard, but her involvement could be of dire importance. It sounds like a truly upsetting event for Penny, Professor. That's why I only trust you, her dear friend, to broach the subject. I will understand if Penny does not want to be involved. However, this could be an opportunity for her to finally heal. You would be instrumental in that. You're right, Professor. If someone is going to ask her about it, I'm glad this is a good friend. Since this is quite a delicate issue, perhaps we should discuss your methods before you go. When you talk to your friend about this trouble matter, how will you approach her? I will approach her with understanding and try to see things as she sees them. A wise choice. Understanding is the path that leads to knowledge, and knowledge is the key to almost any problem. I knew I could count on you. Should Penny agree to help, return to my office together for further instructions. I will, Professor. I'm sure I will find Penny practicing a pose in the potions classroom. I will head there now and see if she is willing to help us take on the werewolf in Goderic's Hollow. I'm getting ingredients for a potion. I will be there shortly. Then we will wait 3 hours.
Hey Penny, I hope I'm not interrupting. I'm just practicing a forgetfulness potion for some reason. I can never remember how the last one went. There's something I'd like to talk to you about, but it is a difficult subject. I just want you to know I understand if you don't want to talk about it, but I'm here for you, no matter what. Thank you, Melody. You've always been a good friend. Of course I wanted to hear why you have come, but I'm a bit nervous. This all sounds quite ominous. I don't mean to come on too strong. It's all right. I'm half distracted with this potion. I really want to get it right this time. But don't I help with your forgetfulness potion? We will talk while we brew and take things one step at a time. Thank you for brewing with me while we talk. It always calms me down. We have enough standard ingredients for now. Dumbledore wants our help with a werewolf in Godric Hollow. Pass me the lee water, please. Dumbledore asks us to make sure an event is holding. Event he is holding is safe. 4 mistletoe berries coming right up. I'm here on Dumbledore's request. How many Valyrian sprints? Dumbledore has a problem that may be tied to your past. Thank you for brewing with me while we talk. It always calms me down. The potion has a soothing smell, I think. It starts to bubble. Dumbledore wants our help with a werewolf in Goldrake's Hollow. We have enough standard ingredients for now. And out of energy. Dumbledore asks us to make sure an event is holding is safe. Pass me the neat water, please. For mistletoe's berry is coming right up. Merlin's beard, the potion came out perfectly. And I appreciate having something to do while we talked. I can't believe Dumbledore thinks a werewolf in Gondor's head has something to do with me. You know how troubled the memory of that summer is to me. I saw my own friend attacked, and I was unable to stop it. But if Dumbledore believes I could save someone's life, I'd like to try. And if it means confronting a werewolf again, this time will be different. I'd like to believe you, Melody, but what makes you so certain this time will be different? You are a powerful witch now than you have ever been. Because you have only grown in power since I met you. You're more powerful than you have ever been. Oh, Melody, how nice to hear. I'm certainly not the same witch as I was this summer. Thanks for believing in me. I've heard all I need to hear. I'm going to help however I can. That's brilliant, Penny. But before we begin, there is something I need to do. What's that, Penny? When I'm against an enemy that scares me, there's only one thing that can put me at ease. Stidian! Of course, we will head straight to the library to learn everything we can about werewolves. After that, we will be ready to talk to Dumbledore and confront the werewolf in Godric's Hedda. Fine, you can use the library, but be careful and quiet. Is Penny alright? She is a bit more excitable than usual. Who would have thought school would involve so much schoolwork? Penny seems quite interested in murals. I hope there is no trouble. It's almost a full moon after all. There you are, Benedy. I came early and gathered every book on werewolf I could find. The more we learn about them, the easier it will be to defeat the one in Godric's Hedda. Remember, Penny, we still don't know exactly what Dumbledore wants our help with. There may not be a fight. Even so, we should be prepared. If we learn everything we can about werewolves, we will know how to help, no matter what Dumbledore asks. Without Wolfsbane and Werewolf lose any shared of his immunity when it turns, probably. This one is quite old. It's particularly falling apart. Not many werewolves' true identities are known. Be careful with those books. Some are irreplaceable. Apparently, the Ministry instituted a werewolf code of conduct in 1637. They say that when a werewolf turns back, they remember everything they did. It seems very few werewolves have even ever turned themselves over to the Ministry. This book claims to have been written by an actual werewolf. Could you turn those pages a little more quietly, please? This book is full of horrible stories. Reading up on werewolves, are you? This is quite a complex subject. And out of energy. This book says werewolves lose all morality once they have been bitten. It asks Wolfsbane, a werewolf lose any shard of his humanity once it has turned. No many werewolves' true identities are known. This one is quite old, it's practically fallen apart. Be careful with those books, some are irreplaceable. Apparently the Ministry Institute, a werewolf code of conjecture in 1637. It seems very few werewolves have ever turned themselves over to the ministry. Could you turn those pages a little more quietly, please? This book is full of horrible stories, just like mine. Reading up on werewolves, are you? That's quite a complex subject. This book says werewolves lose all morality once they have been bitten. This says that when a werewolf turns back, they remember everything they did. Oh my, the more I learn about werewolves, the less I like them. According to Lupine Lawlessness, werewolves are ruthless creatures with no moral sense. Perhaps that is not entirely fair, Penny. It is true when a werewolf transforms without Wolfsbane, it loses any share of its humanity. Exactly. But memories of what they have done stay with them after they had transformed back into a person. I'm sure there are werewolves out there who regret the things they do as a werewolf. Like the narrator of Harry Snout's Human Heart. I'm not so sure, Melody. The Ministry Werewolf's Code of Conduct of 1637 was meant to help werewolves safely integrate, but when it was instituted, very few werewolves came forward. They aren't willing to safely integrate into wizard society. That means they are dangerous. Not at all. Not all werewolves are dangerous on that. You have to trust me. If this is really the werewolf that stole the woods of Wigtown, I can't afford to be indecisive. If it comes near me, I won't hesitate. Not again. Don't worry, Penny. I'm sure Dumbledore will do everything in his power to keep us safe. You're right. I'm getting ahead of myself. I don't mean to get carried away. I just feel quite strongly about this. Dumbledore may only want to informate about what happened. Well, thanks to you, we have read everything there is to read about werewolves. If Dumbledore wants to transform, we have more than enough to give him. Yes, we'll be quite thorough. And I think I'm finally ready to talk to Dumbledore. Then I have to head to his office now and learn how we can help with the werewolves in Godric's Hollow. Please hurry, we have much to discuss and little time to do it. I'm so pleased you agreed to meet me, Miss Haywood. Though I wish it were better circumstance. Melody said you wanted to discuss the werewolf attack I witnessed in the woods of Wigtown. I wasn't certain I could go through it all again. But Melody was quite understanding. She gave me strength. That's why we have come together. I can do this, but only with her at my side. The value of good friends in difficult times cannot be overstated. And I'm afraid these are quite difficult times for some. Professor, you said the werewolf in Godric's Hollow was tied to what happened was tied to what happened to Penny's friend. But you haven't said what you need from us yet. Of course, I don't mean to cause any suspense. With all the planning I've left to do, it's best to take things one at a time. If Miss Haywood is willing, I'd like to start by hearing everything she can remember from that chamber. I'll tell you everything I can remember. But I will need Bellady's help. How can I help, Penny? This isn't going to be easy for me. Once I start, I want you to make sure I don't stop until Dumbledore has everything he needs. Of course, Penny, I'm right here with you. I'll tell you what I remember from the summer. Hopefully, this is the last time I'll ever have to face it. But I first need some more energy. I always thought my presence meant I couldn't protect my friends. Thank you, Penny, for sharing your story. I had my wand, but I froze. No child should have to deal with all of this. It's all right, Penny, I'm right here. My friend is gone because of me. You've done your best to put this all behind you, but the pain is still there. My poor friend Scarlet, she was attacked in the woods of Wigtown. Thank you, Penny, for sharing your story. Go on, Penny, you can do it. No child should have to deal with all of this. It's all right, Penny, I'm right here. My friend was fascinated by a werewolf he saw, but she should have run. And adventure. This is not any. I didn't go back in time enough to finish the story for Penny. We're going to try again. Don't worry, you are safe, Penny. No child should have to deal with all of this. Thank you, Penny, for sharing your story. It's all right, Penny, I'm right here. You have done your best to put this all behind you, but the pain is still there. No child should have to deal with all of this. My friend was fascinated by a werewolf he saw, but he should have run. Thank you, Penny, for sharing your story. It's all right, Penny. I'm right here. I had my wand, but I froze. You have done your best to put this all behind you. But the pain is still there. My poor friend Scarlet, she was attacked in the woods of Wickwood. No child should have to deal with all of this. Go on, Penny, you can do it. Thank you, Penny, for sharing your story. It's all right, Penny, I'm right here. My friend is gone because of me. I'm out of energy, but I think I can get enough if I go to my room. This should be enough, I think. You have done your best to put this all behind you, but the pain is still there. No child should have to deal with all of this. Thank you for sharing your story, Miss Haywood. You suffered a great loss, and I admire your strength. From your conversations, clear the two of you have a bond that will see you through many years, through many challenges. Thank you, Professor. Was that all you needed? I'm sure he wants more than a story. There is still a werewolf on the loose. This won't be finished until it's gates or destroyed. I'm surprised to hear you say that, Miss Haywood. It's quite unlike you. Werewolves are powerful, but it isn't fair to assume they all have mal intent. Many are lost and confused, in need of help. Others simply prefer to take care of themselves. Thank you to your help, we will soon be able to determine this particular werewolf's intentions. I don't mean any offense, but if this is the werewolf that attacks Scarlet, I already know its intentions. I see what it is capable of firsthand. If we were to face it, we can hesitate. The cost is too high. And what about Miss Swan? Do you feel the same as your friend? No, the werewolf could need help. It's like you said, Professor, the werewolf could need our help. It sounds to me like you have been reading Harry Snout, Human Heart, an enlightening text and quite funny. Now I know you feel strongly, Miss Haywood. I ask only that you not rush to judgment during the next part of your mission. What's the next part of our mission, Professor? If you are up for it, I'd like you both to travel to Goldwick's Hollow. So we are going to fight the werewolf? If all go into a plan, there will be no fight of any kind. You will find another one of my guests waiting to fill you in on all the details. Mad-Eye Moody. If anything unexpected should happen, he will keep you both safe. Then let's go. As long as Bellady is by my side, I'm ready. Alright, we are off to Goldrick's Hollow to meet with Mad-Eye Moody and learn more about the werewolf. You and Penny meet Mad-Eye Moody, and your mission takes a shocking turn. I'm on my way. Give me a moment. Okay, I will give you an hour or five. That's not a moment if you ask me, but I will give you the time. There you two are. You took your sweet time getting here. You said you needed to wait 5 hours. Are you Mad-Eye Moody? Dormander sent us to meet you. Yes, and he's told me all about you, Curse-Baker. That's quite a reputation you have. As an hour, you must be quite busy, Mr. Moody. If you come all the way here just for a werewolf, it must be dangerous. Well, suppose werewolf can be a bit nasty. But I was already on my way here when Dumbledore asked for my help. Does that mean you are one of Dumbledore's guests for the gathering in the village square? My, he must really trust you two to give you that kind of information. A lot of people will be interested to hear who's coming to the gathering. It's up to us to keep Dumbledore's plan secret and to make sure there are no werewolves party cursors. Yes, Dumbledore said we could help. Make sure that doesn't happen. He said you fill us in on the details. It's my understanding we have been charged with capturing the werewolf and determine its intention. If you don't do much trying to talk to a werewolf, of course. It won't do much good trying to talk to a werewolf, of course. But if you can't onto it until it changed back, then we can question it. Oh my, that sounds quite difficult. Nonsense, catching a werewolf won't be hard. We just need a plan for how to do it. You mean you don't have a plan? Me? I just said I was traveling. I've had no time to plan. Besides, the mother said you will know exactly what to do when the time comes. He said you are quite good in a crisis. I see. Well, if a plan is what we need, then let's make one. We are running short on time after all. Let's brainstorm a bit and come up with the best way to capture a werewolf and hold it until morning. It's a full moon, so the werewolf is bound to be out tonight. Penny is really rising to the occasion. Werewolves are sometimes drawn to people from their past. If we use the spell, we can control the outcome. Perhaps we could use a spell to bind the werewolf. We want to capture the werewolf, not harm it. If you want to stay safe, we should keep clear of the werewolf. We have studied Petrificus Totalis. Would it be useful? If Penny has a history with the werewolf, perhaps we can use her to lure it. Perhaps Penny and I are quick studies when it comes to spells. I'm doing this to prevent any more unnecessary harm. And out of energy. It's a full moon, so the werewolf is bound to be out tonight. Penny is really rising to the occasion. Werewolves are something drawn to people from their past. If we use the spell, we can control the outcome. Perhaps we could use the spell to bind the werewolf. We want to catch the werewolf, not harm it. If we want to stay safe, we should keep clear of the werewolf. Alright, if the werewolf may be drawn to Penny, perhaps her presence will lure it out of hiding. And once it approaches, we use Purificate Totalis to bind it. Correction, I will use Purificate Totalis. Two of you won't go anywhere near the werewolf. If it all goes according to plan, that is, well, yes, I will bind it. Then we will bring it to an old friend's house and we can safely keep it until morning. But now that you mention it, you should probably review the spell before we do anything else. I want to make sure you both know it as well as I do in case of an emergency. It can't hurt to brush up. Alright, we will practice Purificus Totalis. Once we know it by heart, we will be ready to capture this werewolf. And let's reconfine at my friend's Bathilda Bechold's home. We can practice the spell there and prepare the home for when we capture the werewolf. Great, we'll meet you at Bathilda Bechold to prepare. I'm ready to go practice Purificus Totalis. Let's go now. Whoa, so this is where Bathilda Bechold lives. I've read all her books. What an honor to stand in this very place. She gifted a history of magic. Well, we see Miss Bechold, Moody. Will we see Miss Bechold, Moody? She was quite helpful when we were dealing with Ragnuk. I'm sure you will see her again soon. But Bathilda agreed to let us use her home on the condition that she does not have to be here. She's not particularly partial to werewolves. That makes two of us. Then let's get to work. If I remember correctly, you studied Petrificus Totalis as a part of your future curriculum at Hogwarts. So we could consider the more of a review a very important review. You will both need to know exactly what to do, just in case something goes wrong. Alright, we'll practice Pacificus Totalis and get it perfect. Then we can head out to the capture this werewolf. Yes, I can already start it. You've got it, Penny. That's it, that's it. You two were quite well together. Swish and troll. My, the book is dusty. Bring me back seeing good friends support each other, like you two. This is quite a spell for duels. Let's hope it works as well on werewolves. And out of energy. I wonder if Miss Bishop would mind if I borrow a book or two. Pacific Totalis. Wait, not Totalum, Totalis. I see. You've got it, Penny. That's it, that's it. Like this, or? You two were quite well together. Swish and stroll. Swish and stroll. Bring me back seeing good friends support each other like you two. This great spell for duels. Let's hope it works as well on werewolves. My, that book is dusty. Pacificus Totalum. Wait, not Totalum, Totalis. Now I did it right. You've got it, Penny. I wonder if Miss Bishop would mind if you borrow a book or two. That's it, that's it. And out of energy. Like this, or? You two work quite well together. Swish and swirl. Swish and troll. Bring me back seeing good friends support each other like you two. This is a great spell for duels. Let's hope it works as well on werewolves. My, that book is dusty. Pacificus Totalum. Wait, not Totalum, Totalis. You've got it, Penny. I wonder if Miss Bishop would mind if I borrow a book or two. That's it, that's it. Like this, or? You two were quite well together. Swish and swirl. Great work, you two. You are getting it. Practice makes perfect. Well, want to do a quick final test, but there is something I'd like to say before we do. Seeing you two work together the way you support each other, I'm impressed. You make a good team. Don't take it for granted. You seem a step moody. Are you all right? Oh, I'm just fine. Just wistful is all. It's touching all the trouble Dumbledore has gone to. I don't know how much he told you. But the group he gathered worked quite closely together throughout the recent Missandei War. They did? Yes, and many of us were people who wouldn't have otherwise crossed paths. Working in secret like we did, you have no one to rely on but each other. I was surprised at how quickly he lost touch after the war. This will be the first time I've seen many of them in years. Dumbledore mentioned that, but he didn't say why. There are a number of reasons. No one person is to blame. You only mean to say, don't let it happen to you and yours. Oh no, Mr. Moody, we never let something like that happen, no matter what. I see now Why this gathering is so important to Dumbledore. We will do everything we can to make sure it goes smoothly, right, Penny? Yes, but it's quite important. I'll admit I'm feeling a bit nervous. Really? About seeing the werewolves? Yes, I know Mr. Moody will keep it safe, but if something goes wrong? What if I freeze again when it comes down to it? What if I can't cast a spell? You won't freeze. You can do this. You won't freeze. You can do this, Penny. Just remember what we practiced. You had it perfect then. You're right, Billy. Thanks for having so much faith in me. On my own, it's easy to doubt myself, but with you, I just might be able to do this. Since you are going to be the one casting the spell, in a mercy, Penny, let's see you give it a go. Bye, Melody. You can do it, Penny. Go on. All right. Petrificus totalis. You did it. Yes, excellent work, Miss Haywood. Now, finite incantatum. With that said, I think it's time to go and catch a werewolf. But remember, we are only practicing in case of an emergency. You two will help lure the werewolf out of hiding, but you must not get in his bed. Of course, Miss Moody, he can count on us. Now, let's head to the graveyard and see if we can root out this werewolf and save the Mondor and save the Mondor gathering. It's time to capture the werewolf. Of Godric has hello, hurry. I fear I lose my head if the Mortian hadn't sewed back on. Pooh, just kidding. Welcome, make yourself at home. My grave is your grave. Nosey is nice here in Godrageddon. Do they know some of us are trying to rest? I know hunting murals would be creepy, but I didn't think it would be this creepy. Let's just hope Ragnar doesn't show up. He can be quite moody. Quiet, you two. Night is falling and the full moon is on the rise. And remember, you two only here on the chance the Penny scent could attract the werewolf. When the time comes, I will be the one to capture the werewolf. You two will be safely hiding. Then we can hold the beast until morning and confront the human behind the werewolf. Of course, Moody, we will be safe. We just need to find a spot big enough to hide the two of us. Let's search the graveyard for a hiding spot so we will be safe while Moody catches the werewolf. I need some more energy for that. Out of the way. Perhaps we could climb a tree. You know, this really reminds me of old times. Ragnar Crypt could work provide. Provide we don't wake him. If you like to hide in a coffin, I can lend you mine while I'm out. The crypt is a good position and is quite large. A gravestone simply won't do. We'll need something quite large to hide behind. An invisibility cloak won't cut it. It's good we don't have one. If I use a constellation charm, the wolf could still smell you. If we hide here, we'd be out of the view of the entrance. And out of energy. And let's try behind this crypt. Out of the way. There got to be something somewhere. Perhaps we could climb a tree. Reckon Skip could work, provide we don't wake him. You know, this really reminds me of old times. The script is in a good position and is quite large. Ah, the script is large enough for the two of us to hide behind. It's perfect. It's quite large, yes. You will be out of view of the entrance, which I suspect is where the werewolf will come from. But before I leave you, I must emphasize that your safety is out of the utmost importance. If when the werewolf arrives, do you promise not to get involved? I promise. I promise to stay out of the werewolf's way. We don't want any trouble. Yes, no trouble, thank you. Excellent, I know you had a good head on your shoulders. Now, I better get into position. The werewolf should show up at any minute. Ooh. Or something like that. It's the werewolf. Well, okay, I sounded more like an owl than a werewolf, but anyway. It sounds close. Stay safe, stay hide. Constant vigilance. Violence. Or something like that. I'll be back soon with a werewolf in town. I'm quite thankful for Moody. The last thing I want right now is to be battling a werewolf. For Penny. What was... Penny, was that you? Me? No, I thought it was you. Oh yeah, the werewolf came from the other side. It's nine of us. It's the werewolf. Hurrah. Beatificus totalis. Melody, I'm alright, but cast the spell, hurry! Protificus totalis. I did it! You saved me! I know you could do it. Thanks for believing in me, Melody. I can't begin to describe how good this feels. I did it! I told you to stay out of trouble. Well, the trouble found us. Please tell me you are all right, Melody. I am. It's all, but the werewolf barely scratched me. It's almost like it was trying not to hurt me. It still attacked you. Just because a werewolf didn't rip you to shreds doesn't mean that wasn't his aim. Good work, Penny, if you weren't following my instructions. Now, let's get this beast back to Bessel before some Apple's villagers see it. I'll watch it overnight and you can return in the morning to discover its true identity. I'm a bit nervous to confront the werewolf. Give me a few moments. Okay, I will give you 4 hours. Penny, are you ready to find out the identity of our werewolf? I don't know, my hands have been shaking since we encountered it in the graveyard. You two are just in time. It's a long night watching over our werewolf friend. Here, morning has finally come. But he's about to transform into human again. Then we can find out why it is here. Don't worry, you will be perfectly safe, though you might want to take a few steps back. Oh, I don't know if I can stand it. What's wrong, Penny? I know we are here to learn the truth about this werewolf, but if it is really the werewolf that killed Scarlet, I don't know if I can do as the mother asked. What do you mean? You only said to keep an open mind. Given what it is done, how can I give this werewolf the benefit of the doubt? I know we have friends who disagree, and I don't love myself for feeling this way. But the truth is, many werewolves are monsters, Melody. plain and simple. This may be one of them. I have seen go horrible wrong as a result of inaction. I don't want to risk that happening again. It's too late for a debate. Look, the changes begin. I've never seen this person before. Oh my, what a sight. Oh no. Stay close now, you two. I've got you. It's all right, Penny. I'm here. It can be. That looks quite painful. I've never seen this person before. Oh my, what a sight. Meta will keep us safe. Stay close now, you two. I've got you. It's alright, Penny. I'm here. And out of energy. No, 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 no. That looks quite painful. Oh my, what a sight. It's all right, Penny. I'm here. Oh no. I've never seen this person before. It can't be. It's not possible. What's wrong, Penny? It's not the real of the killed Scarlet. Then who is it? It is Scarlet. What happened? Where am I? Why, she is barely a child. This must be some mistake. Venite incantatum. Penny, is that you? I can't do this. It's not possible. I just can't. Penny, wait. Don't let her go far. We still don't know what's going on. I'll take care of this poor young woman, Billy. You go after your friend. Alright, we'll meet you back here once I find her. Good. Now quick after Penny. If you hurry, you may be able to cut her off in the village square. Penny's world has been turned upside down. Can you arrive right in time for Dumbledore's reunion? It's time to go and talk to your friend Penny. You better hurry. How many tasks are left? 4. It looks nice. Penny, there you are. I'm sorry I ran off like that, Melody. It's just so overwhelming to see Scarlet after all this time. Are you alright? Yes, no, I don't know. I was prepared to confront the werewolf that killed Scarlet. But I don't know how to feel about seeing Scarlet herself. My head is spinning. And the extent how certain this must be. But perhaps some part of you is excited to discover your friend is alive after all this time. Of course, I've wished for this moment for so long. But now that it's here, I'm scared of how it makes me feel. What do you mean? Scarlet's not just alive. She has been hiding all this time. Hiding and living as a werewolf by the werewolf Melody. Who knows what she has done? We can talk to her, Penny. We can learn the answer to these questions. But it hurts, knowing she let me go on thinking she was... Is it wrong to think I may not be able to forgive her? Yes, Scarlett may have had a good reason. I understand being upset, but Scarlett may have had a good reason for hiding. I don't know what she's been through or what she's feeling. You don't know anything. You have the opportunity here to learn the answer to all your questions, Penny. Perhaps you should withhold judgment until then. Oh, you're right, perhaps I should, but I don't know if I can talk to her. I don't know if I have it in me. Of course you can. We've come this far. You know I trust you, Melody, and I value your advice. Help me make up my mind. Tell me why I should talk to Scarlett instead of feeding back to Hogwarts and leaving her alone as she left me. But I need some more energy for this. We don't know what Scarlett has been through. I'm sure she could use a friend. It may be too late for Scarlett to come back. There is so much tenderness in this statue and power. Perhaps I should embrace the time we have together, whatever happens. You promised Moody you wouldn't let you and your friend grow apart. From what you have told me, you and Scarlett were best friends. I believe she was gone for so long. I wish I could have known them. I did miss her. I still do. You don't know what Scarlett has been through. I'm sure she could use a friend. It may be too late for Scarlett to come back. There's so much tenderness in the statue and power and out of energy. Perhaps I should embrace the time that we together have left. You promised Moody you wouldn't let you and your friends grow apart. From what you have told me, you and Scarlett were best friends. I believe she was gone for so long. I wish I could have known them. I did miss her, I still do. We don't know what Scarlett has been through. I'm sure she could use a friend. It may be too late for Scarlett to come back. There is so much tenderness in the statue and power. Perhaps I should embrace the time that we have together, whatever happens. You promised Moody you wouldn't let you and your friends grow apart. From what you have told me, you and Scarlett were best friends. And out of energy. I believe she was gone for so long. I believe she was gone for so long. I wish I could have known them. I did miss her. I still do. We don't know what Scarlett's been through. I'm sure she could use a friend. It's maybe too late for Scarlett to come back. There is so much tenderness in the statue and power. I know this is hard, and if you choose to go your own way, I will understand. But you told Moody yourself that you never let you and your friend grow apart, no matter what. And from what you have told me, Scarlett was a true friend. You're right, Penelope. She was. Despite how I feel, I can't imagine what Scarlett has been through, especially if I don't talk to her. Thank you, Penelope. Without you, this would have been such a mess. Or more of a mess than it is already was. Does that mean you will come back and talk to Scarlett? Yes, but only if you will stay by my side. Of course I will, Penny. Now, let's head back to Bagshot's house and reunite you with your long-lost friend. I'm ready to talk to Scarlett. Let's go. This one I didn't have yet. Kunhilda de Gorsmore, a one-eyed witch and healer who discovered a cure for dragonpox. Nice. Penny, I'm so glad you came back. I found her in the village square. She just needed a moment to gather her thoughts. Thanks. See, I was worried I'd never see you again, Penny. I'm sorry for running off. I was just so overwhelmed to see you. Penny and I came here thinking the werewolf in Gondor's head was the one that attacked you. You can't imagine what it lies to find out it was you. You are the werewolf in Gondor's head. I miss it is like a little like waking up in a strange house, bound by your best friend's magic. You must be quite disorientated, Scarlett. We didn't mean to take you by surprise. It's just a surprising situation. It is, yes, but I'm sorry for how I reacted. She's feeling much better after our talk. Actually, the truth is, I'm quite upset. With me? Of course not, Melody. I was ready to run away, but you reminded me of a promise I made. I realized after everything we have been through, I couldn't just leave Scarlett, not without talking to her first. Thank you, Melody. I'm glad I could help. We were best friends, Scarlett. Time apart shouldn't change all that. But this is a big deal. I can't overlook all that's happened. But before I can move on, I need to know how you could let me spend all this time thinking you were dead. I'm sorry, Penny. I have so much to tell you. Perhaps if you tell us your side of the story, it will be a little easier to understand what's happened. Of course, all I want is a chance to explain myself. Then Penny can decide what she wants to do. My story is complicated, but hopefully, once you've heard it, you can both find it in your hearts to forgive me. But I need some more energy for this. I'm glad you are safe, Scarlett. We came back and you weren't there. We thought the werewolf had taken you. My injuries left me on the edge of two worlds, but something helped me there. Something helped me here. After her attack, I woke alone. My wounds are already starting to heal. I stayed hidden, frightened of how you react when you found out the truth. We were certain you were gone. We held a memorial. When did you know what you become? When you saw us real, Penny, I was near dead. I'm glad you are safe, Scarlet. I'm not eavesdropping. I could stuff my ears with bits of sofa cushions like if you like. It's quite the sight seeing the three of you work this out together. Don't mind me, this is between the three of you. My injuries left me on the edge of two worlds, but something helped me here. After the attack, I woke alone. My wounds were already starting to heal. And out of energy. We came back and you weren't there. We thought the werewolf had taken you. I stayed here and frightened of how you react when you found out the truth. We were certain you were gone. We were held a memorial. When did you know what you become? What you saw was real, Penny. I was near that. I'm glad you are safe, Scarlet. My angels left me on the edge of two worlds. Something helped me to hear. I need you to understand that what you saw was real, Penny. After the attack, I was near dead. Something kept me here. Something kept me alive. Perhaps it was the power of the wolf already taking hold. When we came back after the attack, you were gone. We felt the way of taking you. We were scared, but after weeks, we held a memorial. We searched. Oh, Penny. It must have been unbearable. I'm so sorry. But in a way, the wolf did take me. I woke alone. My wounds are already healing. I was terrifying. Because you know what you become? Yes. I was so obsessed with werewolves as a kid, it wasn't hard to guess what I was becoming. The hard part was knowing what to do next. Thank you for telling us all this. Scarlet, I know it wasn't easy. It's you I should be thanking. Without you, I might never have this opportunity. But that's my point. Only time, not a world. You could have left a clue, a note, anything. I wanted to reach out to you, Penny, I swear, but I was worried you would react me. I understand feeling that way. Werewolves don't have the best reputation in the wizarding world. Exactly, and I had no idea how to control my wolf side. I didn't know how my parents would react. I didn't know how you would react. And it was dangerous. The best I could manage on my own was to lock myself away and hide between full moons. Scarlet, we thought you were dead. I know, it hurts me to say it, but on some level I preferred it that way. I knew that as long as you thought I was dead, you still loved me. Oh, Scarlet, that must have been so lonely. Yes, it was lonely, but more than that, it was frightening. I tried to control the wolf, but it was too powerful. I could lock myself up, but only for so long. This night, all it took was your scent on the wind for me to break my chains and escape. It's pure luck that you captured me instead of doing what you could have done. It wasn't luck at all. It was Melody. It was her idea to use Privateus Totalis, and it worked like a charm. Thanks, Penny. I did what I could. But it was you who cast the spell in the end. You know, Scarlet, if you are having trouble controlling the werewolf, we may be able to help you. Thanks to Penny's careful nature, we had a lot of werewolves before coming here. While doing so, we discovered that you can control your wolf side with the aid of wolfsbane. That's all right. The ingredients are rare and hard to come by, but I'm sure if we are together, we can manage it. How old? Wolfsbane is actually why I came to Golden's Hollow in the first place. But there are no wild ingredients growing here, and no magic shop. I was contacted by a wizard who said they could help. You can imagine my surprise, but they said they were sympathetic to my situation. They offered me one of the potion's rare ingredients if I agreed to meet them in Goddard's Hollow. This seems like more than a coincidence, isn't it? Someone invited you to Goddard's Hollow at the same time Penny and I were sent here. You are sure you have no idea who it was that contacted you? I think it was Dumbledore. It was an anonymous letter. All they asked was for me to meet him in the graveyard this morning. Came to think of it, if we hurry, we might still be able to catch them. Then what are we waiting for? Let's head to the graveyard now and find out who orchestrated this unexpected reunion. Let's hurry, there's not much time left. There is no one here. This is where we... This is when and where my anonymous letter said... Say to meet. Perhaps you missed the person who sent it. I expected you to be older. And a single person instead of three. Lupin, it's you. I've been trying to get in touch with you on behalf of Dumbledore. It's good to see you, Melody. You must be the one who sent me the anonymous letter I received. I thought we knew each other better than that. Me? I didn't send any letters. Well, someone sent me an anonymous letter saying to meet them here. And you are here. How strange. You are here because my friend Scarlet received an anonymous letter saying the same thing. Yes, and they said they could help me find an important potion ingredient. I see. Let me guess. That aconite over there was promised to us both. It's aconite. This is one of the rarest ingredients in wolf, I mean, our potion. Yes, the ingredient, that's the ingredient the letter promised. How strange that you promised it to us both. If you didn't send the letter, Mr. Lupin, and none of us did, then who was it? I'm not sure, but clearly I'm missing some important piece of the puzzle. If you'd be kind as to tell me how all wound up here, perhaps we can solve this mystery. Yes, I can already start it. Cecile Lee searched up a ruckus became of werewolf in Godric's Hollow. I came to Godric's Hollow because I received an anonymous letter. Dumbledore has been reaching out to me for some time. My friend was attacked by a werewolf. I thought she died. Meta Moody was helping us. He will be at the village square soon. I was convinced I'd never see my friend again until all of this. And out of energy.
I had a theory of who sent the letter, but now it is complicated. I came to Godric's Hollow because I received an anonymous letter. Dumbledore has been reaching out to me for some time. We hide right there to the other night. Too bad the werewolf had the same idea. Meta Moody was helping us. He will be at the village square soon. My friend was attacked by a werewolf. I thought she died. I was convinced I'd never see my friend again, until all of this. I had a theory of who sent the letter, but now it is complicated. And Dumbledore has been reaching out to me for some time. We came here looking for the werewolf that attacked Scarlet. We were helping Dumbledore reunite old friends.
Dumbledore asked me to talk to you, Mundungus, and Aberforth on his behalf. Cecile stirred up a ruckus because of a werewolf in Godric's Hollow. I came to Godric's Hollow because I received an anonymous letter. We hide there the other night. Too bad a werewolf had the same idea. My friend was attacked by a werewolf. I thought she died. Meta Moody was helping us. He will be at the village square soon. I was convinced I'd never see my friend again until all of this. I had a theory of who sent the letter, but now it is complicated. Dumbledore has been reaching out to me for some time. We came here looking for the wheel that attacked Scarlet. All right, I think I'm beginning to understand what we are all doing here. I'm glad one of us is, because I'm still a bit lost. Dumbledore has been reaching out for me for ages. But lately I prefer to keep to myself. Like me. Exactly like you, if I'm not mistaken. I think it is no coincidence we are meeting so close to this gathering, Dumbledore explained. It's an event he knows I would have been like to avoid. Have a heart for it beforehand. But you already know about the gathering. Dumbledore said he sent an invitation. I received only an anonymous letter about the availability of this rare ingredient. I should have known there'd be a catch. It's quite cunning. But why will Dumbledore lie? I'm not sure he did. From what you told me, Dumbledore only said he was hoping to reunite old friends who've fallen out of touch. I believe that applies to my old group of friends as well as you two. So Dumbledore did all of this for us? Perhaps, perhaps not. We can't be certain. I only know that Dumbledore believes true friends can endure your anything. And intentional or not, things have a way of working out as he intends. If it was him, then Scarlet and I owe him many thanks, as well as Melody. Without you and Dumbledore, I'm not sure we would have found our way back to each other. I'm glad it worked out for the two of you. You're kind and gentle people. You keep the Echo Knight, young one. I will make do. No, let's split it, Mr. Lupin. I insist. There's plenty to share. All right, I'll take a bit, but then I must go. I trust you know how to use yours. I have a friend who will know what to do with it. Before you go, Lupin, perhaps you will give me a chance to finish my international task. Dumbledore asked me to talk to you on his behalf. Based on his request, if he didn't send the invitation, I think it's fair of me to offer you one. Will you come? I don't think so. It was a mistake to come here, though I appreciate your gift of the Echo Knight. I will split the bundle now and be on my way. It seems these flowers were wrapped in a note. What does it say? For exhibition exceptional dedication to friend old and new in times of great struggle. The following witches and wizards are cordially invited to a special gathering of the Order of the Phoenix. It's your invitation. It's not just for me. The names listed are Remus Lupin, Scarlet Sparks, Penny Haywood and Melody Swan. You mean we are all invited? Yes, we are. Yes, and you should go. And you too, Remus. I'm sure you will meet many unique witches and wizards. For me, as for me, I won't be missed. That's not true. You haven't seen your friends in so long. There are some of your closest friends and you haven't seen them in a long time. Perhaps you owe it to them to honor what you have shared. You're right, it doesn't hurt to hide from them. Well, what you have said is true, Bendy. My situation is complicated. I need some time alone to think this through. But the gathering will be starting soon. If the three of you want to get there on time, you will have to hurry. Oh my, he's right, it's about to start. Then let's hurry to the Phoenix Square and attend the secret gathering of the Order of the Phoenix. I'm ready. Let's head to the Godric's Hollow Village Square. There you are, Bloody. The Cloaks look quite right, don't they? They look nice, Hagrid. A businessman works is never done, but I can afford a brief rest. Thanks to an O-art I worked this week. Don't worry, I accepted all the fur on Matilda's floor after you lot left. It looks like we arrived just in time. Look, there's Moody with Mundungus, an old pairing. And Aberforth, Dumbledore is at the back. Everyone came. You not only brought me and Scarlet together, he made sure Dumbledore's getting worked out perfectly. I wonder who the stranger in the hood could be. I think I recognize the color of the cloak. It's Lupin, he came. Reminding him of how long it's been since he saw his friends must have moved in Beverly. Perhaps. And look, they are all gathering by the Potter Memorial. I've read about the memorial, but I never saw it in person. It's quite beautiful. Yes, it's really something. It seems all the guests are here, but where is Dumbledore? There he is. Thank you all for coming. I know it's quite disunion for some, and others who were nearby still had to rush. I can't begin to describe how much it means to see you all reunited here, friends. Before I join you, I'd like to say a few words to mark this momentous reunion. I first need some more energy. It's quite an electric group, but they seem to at ease with one another. We are here to honor those experiences that bind us to one another. Dumbledore, I will give a fine speech, but next time, perhaps I will say a thing or two. Down in front, I can hardly see the men. Then we turn our back on the past, we turn our back on each other. We are not here to celebrate loss. Thank you for joining me, old friends. It's been too long. My wildest dreams, I couldn't have imagined how this day would turn out. I'm so glad we made it here for this. And out of energy. I don't know if this is enough energy, but we are going to try. Don't mind me, just got something in my eye. It's quite an electric group, but they seem so at ease with one another. We are here to honor those experiences that bind us to one another. Then we turn our back on the past, we turn our back on each other. We are not here to celebrate loss. Dumbledore will give a fine speech, but next time perhaps I will say a thing or two. Down in front and can hardly see the men. And out of energy, but I'm going to watch a video. I'm so glad we made it here for this. My wildest dreams, I couldn't have imagined how this day would turn out. And I'm going to watch another video. Don't mind me, just got something in my eye. And watch another video. It's quite an electric group, but they seem so at ease with one another. In conclusion, though we have gathered a spot of some significance, we are not here to celebrate loss. We are here to honor those experiences that bind us inexorable to one another. Triumph, loss, they shape us equal, however painful they make us who we are. We may sometimes wish to forget, but if we turn our backs on the past, we turn our backs on each other. I'm sure you all have faces to be and places to be and lives to attend to. I only hope those who can will stay for a glass of pumpkin juice and a story or two. Thank you for joining me, friends. How I've missed you. Since Lupin has snuck off. It's a shame, I was just starting to agree with him. Perhaps Dumbledore did have a hand in orchestrating all of this. All I know for certain is that I'm so glad you are back in my life. Me too, I'm a bit mixed up at first, but now all I feel is gratitude to have you back. And I feel grateful too, Melody. I get a sneaky suspicion none of this would have happened without her. I was happy to help, and certainly the best outcome of a werewolf that I've ever had of. Hello, Miss Haywood and Miss Sparks. How wonderful to see you here. Miss Swan, I like a word. Did I do something wrong, Professor? On the contrary, it seems I owe you a debt. You've only made sure all my guests arrived, you handled our werewolf situation with aplomb? I don't know what that word means. Neither was an easy job, I'm sure. But you know what was going to happen, didn't you? You sent the anonymous letter to Lupin and Scarlet. Me? Oh, I write so many letters. I hardly keep track of them all. The words cannot express how happy I am to see such a brilliant reunion of old friends. Perhaps a token of gratitude will express what words cannot. It's a necklace. Thank you, Professor. And did you say your gratitude? Yes. On behalf of the Order of the Phoenix, I'd like to thank you for your service, your bravery, and your friendship. Speaking of the friendship, I say it's time we join our friends, shall we? Achievements. Year 3. And we got a new necklace. Miss V cannot see with this shirt on. Wait a minute. Maybe you could see it with this one. Here it is. Looks nice. Did we also get something new? I don't believe it. But. Oh, a lot of chocolate fox. I don't think we got something new here. Okay, then this was the side quiz. Thank you all for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up or subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And I hope to see you back in my next video. Maybe until then. Bye!